This is part two of a multi-segment series on how to make modified horn or wing tips for an experimental aircraft, in this case for a Sonarai. If you missed the first article, which is a written article, you can find it on sonarai.net under the articles section. This written article goes over the theory behind Horner style wing tips and why you would desire those over a standard squared off or a rounded tip. We're going to make these tips out of pink foam, and we're going to use a hot wire to cut them to shape, similar to the way that you would make a model airplane wing and then sheet it with balsa, except we're going to lay fiberglass over the foam once we get it cut and shaped. What we're going to do in this segment is, first off, we're going to show you how to trace the airfoil accurately onto a set of form blocks. We'll go through the process of sanding it and getting them to shape. We're also going to cover how to cut the foam, the pink foam that we're going to use for the process. We're going to show you how to lay out the form blocks on the foam and get ready for cutting the airfoil shape itself. So, follow along. I hope you enjoy.
Mount a piece of 25 thousandths inch aluminum between the outer skin and the outboard rib for a mounting flange for the wingtip. If you have any irregularities or low spots at the tip, now is the time to fill them with a filler of your choice. Using strips of wood or fiberglass shafts, align your aileron with a neutral position of the wing. Visually confirm that the aileron is in the neutral position. Next, we're going to make the form blocks. The form blocks are made from a 3/4 inch shelving material, which is basically a piece of particle board with plastic laminated on either side. Cut this material into two strips 58 by 8 inches. Drill three holes through the form block into the outer wing rib, and then use three drywall screws to hold the form block in place. After removing the form block from the wing, paint the side that faces the outboard part of the wing with the cheapest black enamel paint you can find. Once the paint is dried thoroughly on the form block, reattach the form block to the outer portion of the wing. Next, we're going to trace the outline of the airfoil. Find a piece of 16th inch welding rod approximately 12 inches long and grind a flat side to one end. On the other end of the rod, make a 90 degree bend to help you control the rod while you're using it. While keeping the sharp part of the rod down, use the rod to scratch the airfoil shape through the black paint into the white laminate underneath. Try and keep the rod as close to 90 degrees as you can to the form block. If the angle gets too great, the trace of the airfoil won't be accurate. Continue all the way around the bottom side. When finished, remove the form block and you'll have an accurate trace of your airfoil. Flip the trace of the airfoil down. Accurately align the blocks and then use three sheetrock screws to fasten both blocks together. Break the screws off so you don't cut yourself. Using a bandsaw, cut out the shape of the airfoil. Using a benchtop sander, sand both of the form blocks together. Sand the airfoil only as deep as the high spots. After the initial airfoil sanding is complete, remove the black enamel paint with a razor blade. Using your fingertip as a guide, draw a thin line all the way around the outside of the form blocks. Next, take your form blocks back over to the sander and sand that line away. This extra space leaves room for the fiberglass later. Before separating the blocks, make sure you draw a reference line at the front of the airfoil. Your form blocks are now sanded to shape and can be separated. Using a fine grit sandpaper, make sure you sand the edges of the laminate or the hot wire might get caught while cutting the foam later. The foam we're going to use is standard 2-inch thick pink foam from Home Depot. Start by cutting the sheet of foam into 8-inch strips using a table saw. Using a chop saw, cut these strips 58 inches. It's important to keep the blocks square both when you're cutting them on the table saw and using the chop saw. The length of the tip is going to be determined by how many pieces of foam you stack together. My tips are 10 inches, so it took 5 pieces of foam. Next, using spray adhesive, we'll glue the foam blocks together. Make sure you coat both sides of each piece of foam. After you spray the adhesive on, make sure you let them set for a bit to get tacky, probably about a minute or so, but when it's right, your finger should stick to it like this. When the glue is nice and tacky, you can start assembling your block. Make sure you pick one end and one side and try as hard as you can to keep them aligned perfectly. We'll use this edge to align the form blocks later. Using firm pressure, push the blocks together and let the adhesive grab. It's a good idea to flip the block over every time you add a new piece. If you don't, your block may end up looking like a banana. It's time to attach our form blocks to the foam. Roughly center the form block on the block of foam. Next, take measurements. First from the leading edge of the form block to the reference edge of your foam. Then from the reference line on your form block to the reference edge of the foam. Then measure and mark the distance of your trailing edge to the reference edge of your foam. When finished, fasten your form block to the foam block with 3 sheetrock screws. Flip the foam block over. Now we're going to take the measurements from the other side and draw them on this side of the foam so we can line our form block up. It really doesn't matter if the center pieces of foam are square, just the top and the bottom piece. If the top and bottom pieces of foam are not perfectly square, you'll have to use a rasp and remove some material. This is where being accurate with gluing your foam blocks together will pay off. Measure and align the leading edge of the form block. Be careful to be accurate here and double check your measurements. When satisfied with your measurements, screw the form block to the foam block with 3 sheetrock screws. After both form blocks are attached, look the whole assembly over. Check your measurements again, and look the block over and just make sure it looks right. Any misalignment of the blocks is going to give a twist to your wingtip. Any twist might cause unpredictable handling characteristics during slow flight or during a stall. That's as far as we're going to go in this segment. In the next video, we'll cover the hot wire and how we'll use the hot wire to cut the foam to shape. If you have any questions or comments, feel free to contact me on sonarai.net. I hope it's been helpful. We'll see you next time.